Welcome to Cheap Joe's Art Stuff. My name is Julie, and I'm here to impart some knowledge to you today via a two-minute art tip. And today, we're going to be talking a little bit about underpainting, a much maligned and mostly forgotten thing that some artists just choose to skip right over. I've been known to do it on occasion, but I can tell you that underpainting, laying down some initial layers of kind of contrasting, interesting color, is a very, very important kind of magical thing to do. Now, granted, your underpainting can take a more traditional role, like maybe if you're doing your underpainting in like umbers and, you know, ochres and stuff like that, just laying in your value structure first before putting, your color arrangement on top of that. That's a very, you know, kind of almost Renaissance way to approach it. Today, what I'm showing you is a little bit more a contemporary way to underpaint. We are going to be doing a little floral here on our Cheap Joe's signature gessoed panel. I do have this kind of like roughed in basically with some just colored pencil to make it like easier for you guys to see. But I can tell you that one of the things I'm going to do is demo a little bit using some kind of weird colors. I have a friend who does some really, really magical landscape and floral paintings, and one of the things she always does is uses like a orange pink kind of as her baseline and stuff. So I'm kind of going to do a version of that where I've got a pink mixed up, which is a base of like a primary magenta and a titanium white, and then I've also got an iridescent copper here that I'm going to use both of them together. I'm going to lay in a lot of the underpainting structure with those two, and then we're going to let that dry. And then you're going to see some staged photographs as I'm working through this thing, so that you can see the kind of interesting color interaction that happens when you underpaint this way. You're always going to have kind of like these little teeny wispy bits of this underpinning that kind of shows through. So it creates an additional color experience for the viewer. Really, really interesting points of contrast inside of what you're already creating. So this kind of underpainting, I think, is really, really kind of fun and sort of important and a nice kind of like color theory play to enjoy. So take a look, see. Let us know if you guys have any questions, and we hope that you enjoy. So have a look, see. Thank you. Okay, so I know it looks like a quagmire, it looks like a complete and total wreck right now, but there will be some additional, of course, layers that we put down on here. This is just to kind of get, you know, the rough shapes roughed in, give a little bit of life and some contrast, but I'll show you some stage photos here for how we bring this thing to a close and how we kind of get to make the most of some of this initial color that we've already laid down. So we hope that you enjoy.